Am I becoming a real YouTuber? Hello, it went so good. Hey, you guys, I'm at a boo. Hey, my lovely YouTubers, welcome back to my YouTube channel with me, your girl, Morgan Tracy J, coming today with another Fearless Friday video. And you guys, I am getting ready to go on a speaking trip. So if you don't know, I am Morgan Tracy J. I speak on faith, fashion, and fearlessness. And as the day that I'm recording this, I'm actually packing for a one-night stay in Dallas. I'm also in the process of packing right now, and I need to go through my list. I always make a list, like you need a travel fit, you need a speaking fit, you need an extra speaking fit if the occasion don't fit that. And then you also need the travel back home fit, you know, all that. So I was kind of making my list, but also I need to do the little nitty gritty, like the makeup, the flat iron, skincare. There's a lot of stuff that you actually take on a one day trip, really. You don't think about it, but it really is. So anyways, I'm gonna start packing right now. I have about 20 minutes till I should be leaving. Let's pack. Let's go minister. And I went ahead and decided to vlog this is because it's Fearless Friday, and I always want to challenge you to be fearless. And also, you guys, I'm breaking out, hormonal acne vibes going on over here. And I was like, this is just so not the right time. Acne makes me feel so insecure. And I'm like, oh, this is, but you know what? You got to be fearless. And God don't care about your acne breakout. He don't care that you are, you know, not feeling your 100% right now because you're a lady. God, he ain't worried about that. What he's worried about is you get out there and you do what he's called you to do. So even though I'm breaking out acne-wise, thank God we have makeup. Thank God we have pimple patches. So that should be good. Hopefully my pimple patches will help it chill out for a little while. And then the makeup will help kind of cover it a little bit so it doesn't feel like an eyesore. Because it literally feels like an eyesore to me right now. Me being fearless regardless of my acne, regardless of life, still showing up and doing what I've been called to do. So anyways. Okay, you guys, I'm actually packing up and I decided to take an extra outfit just in case I want to go to a church in Dallas tomorrow morning when I'm gonna be leaving. I thought I could get up early, go to church or something. But anyways, I actually got this PR package from Lancome. I'm like, am I becoming a real YouTuber to be getting PR from Lancome? But anyways, I'm gonna show you what's in this box, okay? It is Lancome collabing with Marie Phillips. I don't know who that is, but hey, shout out to Marie Phillips. Okay, and they sent me such a cute little card. That's so cute. And then there is the wrapping paper. And you guys, they sent me Lancome mascara, Lancome travel size SPF. I actually need to use some of this today. Also, they gave me a liner. I need a good wing liner. Also, they gave me some concealer. Like, these three boxes are all different concealers. And I'm like, oh, perfect timing, me going on this trip to go speak. But also, this little situation over here, you know? So they even gave me a juicy tube. This is the lip gloss of theirs. Like, come on now, Lancome. So that's lip gloss. They even gave me some, like I said, concealer, Ultra Wear concealer. And they also gave me another version of the Ultra Wear Glow. Oops, sorry, upside down. This is the all over concealer. Like, you can wear this one like a foundation. So it was just, I'm so happy to have this package. Like, it just felt so good. And there was one more item in here. It was something to do with age defying or whatever, but I ended up giving it to my mom because I thought, oh, she actually would like that. So, so shout out to this PR package from Lancome. It looks so, like, it literally makes me feel like a real YouTuber. Am I becoming a real YouTuber? Like, am I becoming a real YouTuber? But also, I was gonna tell you guys this. If you're feeling insecure about anything, I always want to tell you to overcompensate in another area. What I'm trying to say is, I knew I was feeling so insecure about this whole situation over here. So I was like, you know what? I'm going to do my lashes. I'm going to do my nails. And honestly, I've been giving myself a nail break from the like real acrylics because my nail beds are crazy. So I just went and did the little glue-on Walmart nails. Okay. And they're probably good for about a good day, which is great because that's, I'm just speaking today. That's it. After tonight, I'll pop them off. We'll be good to go. But aren't they cute? You wouldn't know. They were glue on. Okay. So I just gonna do that. But I will say I decided to do the lashes and do the nails to kind of help me be a little more confident. Because I know this whole situation on my face sometimes can make me like want to hide. You know what I'm saying? Guys, I made it to Dallas, and you cannot go into a hotel without doing a hotel tour, okay? So I'm getting ready to show you my hotel real quick. When you walk through the door, you can just go straight this way, and this is kind of the main area. This is like the bedroom area. I think it's on the 40-something floor. Also, the TV is spinnable, so like you can spin it for this room or the living room, depending on what area you're at. This is cute. Okay, so this is so cute. Area here to play some music, and I know I'm gonna utilize this, but anyways. And then here is like the little kitchen area. It's actually a pretty good stocked little kitchen for a hotel. And then microwave. Here's the coffee maker, refrigerator, obviously nothing in it. Here's the fridge. Here's the little table. Ooh, that's so sweet. Also, here's the view of Dallas. This is like, I'm like 50 some feet in the air. It's crazy. Look how high up we are up here. Oh my gosh, that's kind of scary. That's so cool though. Here's the living room area. So cute, so pretty, posh. Now I want to show you the bathroom. I think the bathroom is always a good selling point. Oh, here's a closet. Oh, this is a very nice size closet, actually. Like this is a good, like, you're usually not seeing closets that size in a hotel. All right, you guys, so there's a washer and a dryer, which is good, which I'm not gonna be using, but still good to have. Now here's the bathroom. I do believe hotel bathrooms are the selling point, okay? Hi guys, okay. Then let's talk about the shower. Oh yeah, I'm gonna take a good shower tonight in this place. Like, is it sit down? Oh my gosh, it gets a vibe. It's definitely lush. Matching nightgown set, because if you ever want to do devotion and stuff, which you probably will, if you have a cute nightgown set, you can take some good photos and they still look pretty cute. Anyways, this is just a content creator. Trusting free, you know, walking because it's blood on me, you know, living because it set me free. Trust and believe, you can trust and believe. And when you look really bad, you just wear shades because it just makes you look like you were supposed to look this way. Just wear some shades and act like everything's all good. Okay, let's go. I usually would not show this, but I'm actually walking through my message And I'm kind of just like walking through it, praying. Also, I want to go ahead and make sure I'm on the right page so I don't have to thumb through my Bible. That's something I always make sure beforehand. Like, I'm on the page of the specific scripture that I'm first talking about. And even if I'm talking about additional scripture, I always add little sticky notes in my Bible so it's quicker. Because sometimes when you're speaking, you can get nervous, you can get sidetracked. And so sometimes you need to like, and usually you're on a, you have a time limit. So you need to kind of keep flowing, right? So anyways, and I got a hold of the concierge service here, and they're gonna bring a printed copy of my sermon to my door. And so that's such a blessing. Usually you gotta go downstairs, or you gotta go to the print center, but this one's a little more fancier, and they're gonna just bring it to my door, which is so great. And I mean, they probably don't realize they're bringing a sermon, but hey, they're probably gonna look at it like, what is this about? But after I walk through it maybe one more time, I'm gonna start getting ready, because obviously you can tell I am not ready to go. I have no makeup on still. I did prep my skin a little bit more because, you know, I got all these problems in faces, but I'm gonna start getting ready. But first, I gotta give that time to the Lord. And so I wanted to just hop on here and share that, because before you can go minister, you first have to be prepared, but then you also gotta get out of the way. Because you can't bring transformation or healing. You can just speak the words God gives you. The rest is up to the Holy Spirit. So I'm just trying to prepare my heart and myself, but then I'm also trying to get out of the way so God can do what only He can do. And so hopefully the ladies get blessed by what I'm talking about tonight. And prayfully you'll see that clip later on as well. But I'm just so excited to be here and truly to being fearless towards my dreams. I'm just glad to be here. This is a part of the dream. Even though you haven't made it to the pinnacle, this is part of the dream. That protects, someone that teaches,
yeah.
And someone that guides.
Mm-hmm.
So Mordecai was telling her, hey, I'm not going to teach you about God, but as you watch my life, you're going to see God. Mm-hmm. So as Esther was in that home cleaning and doing her daily rituals, she was seeing God in Mordecai. Mm-hmm. So when she got out of Mordecai's house and stepped into the palace, Mordecai was like, okay, she knows what I taught her. And see, sometimes that happens with us. God will say, okay, I'm going to let you go out here. And then we're like, God, hold on, where are you at? And He's like, I know what I taught you, daughter. So when I put you in that other position and I'm trying to give you more territory and get you to step into your calling, you're still trying to hold my hand when I said, I know what I put in you. Go out there and do what I called you to do. All right? It said that when Esther was preparing to be queen, Mordecai kept coming around the palace, talking to the servants, like, hey, is Esther good? Is she good? She's good, all right. So when Esther was in her preparation journey, preparing, getting herself together, Mordecai was walking around checking on her. And I got a word for somebody today. He knew what he taught her. So he didn't have to keep her in his house. He could let her go into another house because he knew what he put inside of her. And some of us are fighting the new houses God is trying to take us to because we're like, God, I don't know if I got enough. And he's like, I knew what I put in you, daughter. I spoke that word over you when you were a child. You know your calling. You know the vision. You know the purpose. Step into it. And we're like, hold on, God, but I don't want to go into this new place. I'm so scared. God, I don't want to go further. And he's like, daughter, I know what I put in you. Go, girl, go. Because guess what? Even when you think I'm not, I'm actually walking around the palace.
spiritual daughter of God, even when you think I'm not there, I'm actually walking through your room at night, making sure. And you see, one thing about Mordecai, it says that at the right time, he would step in and counsel Esther. See, sometimes we are still wanting to be in our baby faith with God, where he holds our hand and leads us step by step. But he says, okay, now we got to get on to bigger things. And he says, so when you were 2 years old, I had to hold your hand. Mm-hmm. And I had to keep saying, you're a beautiful daughter of God. You are the apple of my eye. You are the above and not beneath. You are called and chosen and set apart. He said, but when you got 16, your mama said, okay, go to your friend's house because I know you'll be home by curfew. Mm-hmm. And God says, so okay, when you got older, I could send you out because I know what I taught you. You're still going to be down. And he's saying this with Esther. It says that Mordecai kept walking around the palace once in a while. And he would check on her. And then he would counsel her. But what happens is sometimes we get so caught up in our journeys and we don't see a breakthrough. And we're like, God, you don't give me the chills like you gave me in the beginning of my walk. God, you don't speak to me like you spoke to me in year one. And God says, but daughter, you were a baby in year one. I had to sing lullabies. I had to speak to you like that. But now that you're a teenager in this, I can give you a whisper and you got the revelation. I can give you one scripture and you got it now. But before, I had to speak it slowly. And I had to keep saying it over and over. You're beautiful. You're strong. You're good. You're called. You're going to speak to women. I want to tell you guys, for years and years, God had a whisper went in that represented him.
Come on.
And God is saying, now, we don't have to have a Mordecai anymore. See, Esther didn't have this word. We do. We don't have to have a Mordecai because he wants to be that. And I want to tell you this today, daughter. Maybe the reason you're moving around and finding yourself in new places is because God knows what he put in you. And he knows that he can trust you in different locations now. You know, there was a season when my ministry just got started and I was on a college campus with a lot, like five women. And that's where I started it at. And then before I knew it, it went to online and it started to grow in different places. And I'm like, hold on, Jesus, no, how did all this happen? I trust you because what I taught you in that dorm room, what we were speaking about at them small five group of Bible studies, now I can give you 50,000 because you got it at the five.
Yeah.
On him. I don't know if this is for you and your walk with God. I don't know if it's because things took too long. I don't know if you've been growing weary and well-doing. I don't know if it's because you've been having this dream year after year or this goal, and now it feels like it is not even possible. It feels further away than it ever has felt now. God is saying, don't give up on him. And he also said, forgive him. Because he didn't do it in your timeline. Forgive him.
Okay. Hey, you guys, I met a boo.
Hey, you guys, my name is Shivania, and I'm here at the Holy Night. Thank you, Sarah, for having us. It was amazing.
Those are some HBC boos. Hi. Say hi to the vlog. Hi.
You're my type of girl with the pink pants.
Yes.
I do not. I need some pink, like hot pink pants like that.
I want a picture with all.
I'm so sorry.
Okay, yeah,
okay. Hello.
It went so good.
It was the bomb.
She did amazing.
Thank you. Morgan, why weren't you here?
She's an amazing speaker. Y'all should have came if you didn't come.
I didn't pay them to say this, okay? I did it.
Y'all, this girl came from Baytown, Texas. We've been sitting here talking and we're tired. It's like almost what? It's like 11:11. Okay. Ooh, okay, Jesus.
Okay.
But it's 11:11 and we are tired and we had a good day. And she rode a bus and came here. Yes. The girl did it. She did it. And look, and God has been good to her, you know? So anyways, I'm so happy to have met you. And we literally feel like friends. We're just chilling. I was like, who would have thought?
Who would have thought?
And I was like, you come to an event and you're just chilling in the lobby and we're just talking about Lord knows what. Okay, you guys. Well, I'm going to tell you. I am so tired. It's literally midnight. I stayed down there chatting with one of the girls that traveled here to hear me speak, and it was so good. Like, I was so tired, but I was really, really thankful for that moment. Because the truth is, when was I gonna get that again? Like, when am I gonna get a time to just sit down with his daughter's closet girl and just chit chat and talk, right? Like, when? So you gotta really like honor those moments when you have them. But anyways, you guys, I am exhausted. This Fearless Friday was so great, and I enjoy ministering to women and stuff like that. But I think I always say, like, the real ministry is when you come off the stage and you intermingle. Like, I can minister from the stage all day long, and I'm so grateful for that. But it's the ministry I do off the stage, like at the events. So to me, I think that's the most powerful part of ministry. But anyways, you guys, obviously I'm exhausted. These little glue-on nails stuck on all day. Like, I'm so shocked because I'm hard on nails. My Fearless Friday challenge to you is to show up truly for your dreams. And you know what? I vision myself in my pink blazer with my feathery top, which I know I dress crazy, but still, walking on that stage and ministering to God's daughters. And I've been envisioning just ministering for a long time. And so just getting to do that tonight, it always warms my heart, and it always lets me know that I'm on track. So yeah, but anyways, y'all, I've got to go to bed. I ain't gonna make it too much longer. Good night.
Duty. Trusting free, you know I'm walking because it's black zone.